Good evening, everyone. We're gonna start by singing the Sound of the Battle Cry, page 413.
So Session, depending on how many people I get. And so be praying for me. It'll be starting at around 9 every Tuesday. And then there's another guy that wants to help pray for the this other guy from Tuba City. His name is Vernon Sanajini. He wants to get in on it, so I hope he'll qualify. You have to have a background check and all the stuff you have to go through. So pray for him, and then that's Sunday is our Thanksgiving potluck. I'll continue to read the book of Revelation. Prayer requests, say, weekly ministries at Tuba City. And pray for church members and their families. Pray for those that are affected by COVID-19 and their comfort for the family. We have known some close friends that lost their loved ones just probably a couple of weeks back. And then pray for our leaders. Pray for our country. That will come back to the Lord. So if you have not been here so many times, we do have an outline that we do, and that's why I preach from. And so I hope you have that, just in case. A lot of times I don't get to read all the verses. And for that reason, you have all the verses that need to apply to this. Of course, encourage you to last out. Now, keep on in our lives, that nonsense. Put on your sour ashes now. I call the arm in the city. What land of a toy, any bear husband or listen, any car. So another young guy, after he takes out his stoneware, that all the other chests and chests, those items that he does, and then he went on stone. So, yeah, before being back, Tuesday. Next week, he has some thank you for listening. Okay, we'll go ahead and open our Bibles to the book of Acts. And then we'll begin there. And we've been going through the book of Acts, chapter 22 is our last part of that reading, or last 25. And as they bound him with thrones, Paul said unto the centurion that stood by, "Is it lawful for you to scourge a man that is a Roman and uncondemned?" When the centurion heard that he went and told the chief captain, saying, "Take heed what thou doest, for this man is a Roman." Then the chief captain came and said unto him, "Tell me, art thou a Roman?" He said, "Yea." And the chief captain answered, "With a great sum obtained I this freedom." And Paul said, "But I was freeborn." Then straightway they departed from him which should be examined, have examined him. And the chief captain also was afraid. You know, somebody's going to be afraid. And that's what this guy was saying to me about testimony. Some are afraid of you. And after that, he knew he was a Roman because he had bound him on the morrow, because he would have known the certainty wherefore or why he was accused of the Jew. He loosed him from his bands and commanded the chief priests and all their council to appear, and brought Paul down and set him before them. Heavenly Father, thank you again for the morning. We pray for just a little bit of help from you, Holy Ghost of God. We need you this morning to give up what is necessary, and there are things that I might put in this, my own doing. So help them to get what they will be beneficial to them, those that are hearing. And may the application, the direction of the message help somebody in this world. Well, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Oh, there you are, freedom by your tea. You see, that I should have wrote down the 26th verse. He claimed to be a Roman. And then the end of 28th verse, he said, "I was freeborn." The other guy said, "I bought it. I bought my freedom." And so that would be my main text. And the question is, which freedom? We're living in a world of a land that's free. We call it free, but we don't know how soon it will slip out of our hands. Yeah, America the country, the way from the White House down, you have the direction they are trying to guide our country, and you notice the soldiers are being, I heard that there are many soldiers are quitting because of direction that our country is trying to give them. And then even policemen, and even heard that there are a lot of robbery and stealing in the San Francisco area from just people that would knock the door open and rob stores. And then some stores have to close. And that's our country these days. We're supposed to be a free country. But that's not what you see these days. It's changing and changing all the time. And that's why we need to sound out the gospel a little bit more than we have before. Alright, we look at the two parts to this message. It should have about three parts too, but select that one in somewhere, and then we have the citizen's freedom. And that's what we have in America, yeah. There's a guy out of New Mexico that was told that we don't have family plot anymore in New Mexico. I guess they were saying a chapter house that we won't loan you a tractor because this is your family plot and we don't authorize that. And if you want to have somebody dig the grave for you, you do it yourself. We have no say in that. Just leave us alone. And that's America. I had it lined up a certain way, but I just want to go through it again. And verse 25 says, as they bound him with thrones or cuffs, Paul said unto the centurion that stood by, is it lawful for you to scourge a man that is a Roman and uncondemned? In other words, they didn't have a trial. How can you whip a guy that has not been, you don't know what the deal is, you don't know what the accusation is, but you whip a person, and then he says, is it right to do that? And then 26, a centurion heard that, and he went and told the chief captain, his boss, saying, take heed. In other words, watch out what thou doest, for this man is a Roman. Roman, Leila. It's just like saying American, he's an American. So be careful what you do. Give him the freedom that he deserves. Give him maybe a lawyer that he may need to help his case. And so he said, be careful about this man. Just watch out. Don't make any mistakes. And then verse 27, the chief captain came and said unto him, tell me, art thou a Roman? People like to know ya. Hey, that being the Ashani Roman, the Nand of it on in the Oe. Neither. And then this other guy wants to cut in, and the chief captain answered with a great sum obtained I this freedom. And Paul said, but I was free born. You know, that's I was born in the country that was already free. But it won't happen with a Christian yet. A lot of churches across America believe that if your family are Christians, you automatically become a Christian. No, you don't. You need to get saved the same way they did. And so you're not as free born as this guy. Yes, in America you can. You are automatically a citizen of America. And yet, you know, years back, I actually obtained my birth certificate when I was about 70 some odd years old. So I was an illegal alien for 70 years plus in my own country. And I would go to the vital statistic in the Phoenix, and these Mexicans would say, you're not legal. Citizens of America, and they themselves aren't, and they tell me that. And so, you know, this is America. You can encounter that too. Adonado, ne ekon e yat, ne Romans, oh, ne landes, ne e shabit, and ne lao, hei peso, sitan nipte, ekon e huntle, she has late freedom, only hacky Paul, she had a fortune. So he said, what they say, American, but America beats it. This is true. I can't be it on us. Oh, Jonah. So when the Otlana is in the late, I go what the church on a Nand. The man Jenny is Otlana. Not it eat land, it on. Not so lot on behind you, it on it. And then, see. And then verse 29, then straightway they departed from him which should have examined him. And the chief priest also was afraid. You know, they were afraid because they were misusing freedom under the Roman government. And that can be so in America. You know, I hear that the our Second Amendment is being attacked, and there are some other amendments that are being bothered or put on hold. And we got an outline. Is one that I give them an outline? And there's one out there, and we're actually reading out of Acts 22. Verse 25 through 30, and so we're looking at verses that we're talking about, and freedom. The Bible calls it liberty, and I think freedom would be more useful to understand to you than all of us. You know, in Matthew 10, 34, under A, or your first arrow, would, you know, the price. You know, there's a price to get freedom, yeah. America fought many wars to stay free and maintain their freedom. Matthew 10, 34 says that Jesus came not to bring peace, but a sword. You know, there will be fighting in the family. You'll disagree with your brothers, you'll disagree with your sisters, you'll disagree with everybody in this world. We're in a sense at war among ourselves. And you know, God would like us to come out of that. First Corinthians 9, I kind of think I was not going to read it, but I'll go ahead and read it. First Corinthians 9, 27. I quote the first part of the verse. And he's cut on this 7. 9:27, okay. Did I say 9:27, chapter 9, verse 7. Who goeth a warfare at any time at his own expense, own charges or expenses? You know, a soldier have to be paid, yeah. Soldiers have to have their uniform, a soldier have their weapons, their guns, bullets. They have to have their machine, they have to have vehicle to fight the war with. You know, it costs something to go to war. You know, it has a price tag. Somebody shed blood, yeah. Back when the Vietnam War started, I was wanting to end the war, but I was disqualified in Albuquerque and came back. And then I look at Navajo Times and the headlines. I said, first Navajo soldier killed in Vietnam. And his name was Alvin Chester, but lately they actually put another guy in there who first casualty in Vietnam from the Navajo Nation. But I remember Alvin Chester was the first guy that was shot. He died in Vietnam. So, you know, it cost somebody something, yeah, a life, bloodshed, you know, some disabling. PTSD syndrome, they come back with even some diseases, and then they might even have some difficulty adjusting back to American life. You know, it costs somebody something, yeah. And, you know, freedom is that way. You can't get freedom easily. And that's why we are here in church, so we can get something from Jody Kwan, Aiden, the next is the price to stay free. You know, America is not trying to stay free, yeah. Withdraw the troop, no, yati. Superpower hit the name that Russia don't hit at a yet all bikini. What I don't know, he's on top. Maybe we're just among the other groups, but the superpower used to be America and Russia. And they were, you know, when they say something, do something, everybody pays attention. But they, America, it on the hard on that one and then. We're afraid. Go to 2 Samuel 22. That's in the Old Testament, right? Yeah, close to the end, beginning of the book. If you have a New Testament, it's going to be closer to the front side. And there we'll look at a verse there, 1 Samuel 22 and verse number 33. So, by the one there, will ye? So, yada, do it a quick sort of honnez, not at a honnez, not a what need. It would a quarter at all this. I it as best in a da da ha chilia. Ah, na, what notion in it? Ah, what a? Ah, then, na, what law you're saved, but you still have an enemy. You're saved, you can't get called, you're saved, you can't get disappointed, you're saved, yet you might get discouraged. But there's an enemy out there still lurking in the darkness. Is that what it is? Is that in the door chitting? And now, look at 1 Samuel 22:33. God is my strength, thank God for that, and power, and he maketh my way perfect. Samuel is saying that there. He's recording that. If he's not saying that, he's recording that. Verse 34, he maketh my feet like hinds' feet. The hind feet is your power. And then it says, and setteth me upon my high places. Verse 35, he teaches my hand to war. Psalm 41:1, it says my fingers to war. We know how to fight, yeah. Yeah, I know how to fight. If America becomes a communist country, you might have to defend yourself. So that a bow of steel is broken by my arms. What a confidence, yeah, when you're saved. You're going to have some confidence in this world. And verse 36, thou hast also given me the shield of thy salvation. And thy gentleness had made me great. Wasn't America great, yeah? You know, God overlooked. Blessed is a nation whose God is the Lord, yeah. Psalm, get that. They in God, yeah. When the Constitution was made, God was put in there. There's a lot of freedom that were given to us now. They're trying to redo those Constitution, yeah. Back then, probably people have a good wisdom to know God is the one that we need to trust. But nowadays, it's changing. America, to maintain this freedom, there needs to be some appreciation, yeah. you know, that these days, you know, I go to different events. One of my friends was in Navajo Times being honored, and he served like 25 or years or more. And he does the military salute for the funerals. And he said that our country is desecrating our flag. He said they would put pictures on the flag itself of their own picture. That's not what it's made for. He said, I'm disappointed when I see these people on the road selling beads. They would have flags up that makes a mockery of our freedom. This is a guy that went to Vietnam. He's about my age, and he knows what he's talking about. So, you know, America is not being appreciated. Now, people came back from the Vietnam War, and they threw eggs and watermelon and tomato at them. They're not appreciated. If you do appreciate this freedom, you know, it's going to be good. Thank God I'm still able to go to the Tuba City on Fridays. And yet, out of that, there are some white folk that were doing this to me. And looking at me. So, hey, this is the Navajo land, so I can do what I want to do. Maybe out there in another state, they might do that. Yes, let them do that. But this is a different country they came to. And we still appreciate, military people. I hope you do. You know, my brother was in the war. I think it was the later part of the Vietnam War. And then my brother's children went. And then my own son, then my grandson, two grandsons and one daughter, granddaughter, in the active military service today. So I appreciate that, you know, that they're trying to maintain our freedom, yeah. And yet, we don't appreciate that. What do they go through then, when they are out there? Hard either she they cause a lot of sort of little than it's in the Benda, 4 or 5 in the morning, and he didn't cut off. Grandson was saying that. And then we had to run 10 miles. For what? Stay in condition so you can fight. Mm-hmm. Have a 50-pound pack on your back and a rifle. Run the hills. You know, that's pretty tough to go through, but he said that's what we took. And so I appreciate it. You know, thank God that they're still able to defend our land. The place, third one, the place of freedom. And that's probably what I was saying, that we're in America. America was free when we were born, yeah. So we don't have to flex our muscle, yeah. We're in free land. But with Christianity, it's different. You know, Christian liberty, Christian freedom is presented to you. You can have it or you can reject it. I was thinking about the person in hell. He said, I have 5 brethren. I want Lazarus to go back and witness to those people. At least he's honest in hell, yeah. They need to get saved. as line as Tini Tate Esco, the Shabbos Hoton, Hotoka, and Hito Katana. There's a gnashing of teeth, and the Bible talks about hell as a place where there's a gnashing of teeth. The never will hit it. Have you ever done that? You know, when you are hit with the worst pain that you can feel, you actually will grind your teeth. And I did that a couple of times in my life. When that pain is so hard, you can't do anything. You can't soothe it down. You can't ice pack it. You can't shoot it or anything. It's so hard, painful. You just grind your teeth. And that's hell. And then the Bible talks about that it's where the worm never die. Worm never die. I used to think about the creepy crawly thing. And then somebody preached on that and they said the worm of your mind, meaning the makeup, the just the liveliness of your brain, is going to be complete in hell. And then you're going to remember people that you left behind. You're going to remember people that tried to win you to the Lord. You're going to remember every chance that everyone had trying to win you. And you'll remember that. You might even remember the names. And you'll remember that for eternity, upon eternity. And where the worm never dies. So I think that's memory. It's going to be there with you. What a place. I mean, there are people that I witnessed to up and down the valley that died without the Lord. And they probably hear me down there. They probably heard what I was trying to win this guy to the Lord. He said, no. I went to church. I didn't ask about that. He said, I was on there preaching for a while. I said, I didn't ask about that. I said, are you saved? And he said, I have my own religion. Okay, you got your own. And so that's what they're going to be set and remember down there. They said that to me, and they'll remember me as clear as 2020 vision. Yeah. There was the chief telling me that, I remember that. I said, no, why did I do that? I trusted my TP and all the works that are in it. Why did I do that? That's going to be forever and ever. So I was thinking about that. To bohot in the chat at all now to car in the nishi. To is in the no a aho. How she done a jot and only. According to Ada, what he does discuss Ada, at the Nashi kiss and lady slana. Shabbat and endo Ado quarter door cast with nano car. According to the one that I thought had ne Ada Hollow. The door ne. A call out on the eight or a day that's an agent, the heads of the Hadas, Etchuk, a day long head, a hurry, the yeet net as he claimed. ASA Bahant or this or your eight days need or less. A cohesion had your heart, the embers on the shore, I saw the inkla. Jehadi need it or what else? Better your name, Huyen, ah, Huyen, ah, do a jo e yan le na se na hot ap ta se ba o ko ne to to a yi se a te ke a fund le ki san le da And that Christian freedom, yeah. Christian freedom, out none aid a store or bound there or a lia. A height out. What did it cost somebody for me to be savior? Hela eha ne like and law is she started shafa shadia. Trust I can laya. I put out a study shaf. I looked up with Ashi. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Just some simple verses that you may have heard before. But we'll read it again. Romans has come. Adonai et ata. Astonas et ata. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God? And ye are not your own, for you are bought with a price. A price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Look at Galatians chapter 3. We want to kind of move quickly. Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law. You know, the law is if somebody say, I want to get saved by the law, they're not supposed to break any of it. If you break one, you break it all, break them all. Being made a curse for us, for it is written, curse is everyone that hangs on a tree. You know, Jesus was that curse. He was the curse on the cross, because we were that. We can't make it, so he had to die in our place. According to the Naha, it's an old card. Look at Hebrew chapter 9. And then verse number 12, I think. 9:12. All right, it says, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. This is talking about heaven. You know, down here they had an earthly tabernacle, where the priest would go to the first part of the tabernacle every day, and then once a year they would enter the most holy place once a year. And that was a type that was in heaven. So when Jesus died, he actually took his blood to heaven and then went into that holy place and apply the blood so you and I can be saved. So it cost somebody the blood. This one has named Jesus, but this is not. One has named this one. Look, yeah. How about going to Romans chapter 5:9? Much more than being now justified, that word is just as if you have not sinned. You know, God clears you of any account of sin when you get saved. Being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. You know, he is taking us away from that wrath that he's going to have on those that don't believe the Lord. He delivered us from that by his blood. How about Revelation chapter 1, verse 5? You might know this one real good. For some of you children probably have that as your memory verse sometimes. This is a good verse. Okay. Revelation 1:5. And from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that love us and wash us from our sins in his own blood. So if you're a saved, you're a blood washed Christian, born again. You get that? You too, God, to the boy over there. Did you get it? Your brother get in that manner? Amen. You know, it costs something. How about Luke 7:46? This is actually I want to admit what somebody said to me when I got really on fire for the Lord. And this auntie of mine was talking to me. I think she had tears in her eyes. She said, because, and this is what she probably was saying here, Luke 7:47, wherefore I say unto thee, her sins, which are many, are forgiven, for she loved much, but to whom little is forgiven, the same loveth little. So you understand your life full of sin, yeah? And then you realize what God did for you. All the bad things in your past. You know, God actually washed those away. Bad habit, bad words, bad attitude, the way you treat it. Hey, God clears that, cleans you. If you do understand that, hey, that's what it is. You love the Lord more. My auntie said, because you were a wicked person, you used to drink, you used to fight, you used to hate people, you used to chase people's cows, cattle. You were very destructive. And now God saved you. And that's the reason you love the Lord more. She was right, but her son, she didn't think she had any. Probably a nice person. They went to mission school and they did okay. Didn't hurt anybody. Parents were already saved. So her understanding of salvation is according to what she thinks. But my sin and her sin are equal. No different. So how you understand that forgiveness is how you're going to love the Lord. And that's why a lot of people don't go to church, because they don't understand how much were you forgiven. You know, we're bad. We're rebellious. We're just sore in the eye of society. And then when you get saved, hey, You want to do something? That's why this guy that wants to do the jail ministry with me, you know, that guy was stoned out with that drug when he would be walking through to the city. That flea market or swap meet, this is it. He will be very drunk and just stagger through. And one day he got saved, and he told me, he said, "I got saved." And he loves the Lord now. He said, "I want to go talk to the inmates." Sure. That's the difference. If you understand what forgiveness is, you are as much forgiven as I am, but your understanding of it may be not as I do. So that will be the difference. The love for the Lord is if you know how much you've been forgiven, God will be your focus. And then the place of freedom, the snow. You know, freedom, somebody said, is not free. That's why we have our soldiers, yeah. Even though we're a free country, we still have to have our weapons, we still have to have our soldiers. You know, you as a Christian, you are free. But if you want to stay free, then you have to do something, yeah. I mean, down here in heaven, you're actually going to heaven. That's no problem, but down here, you're going to have a practical freedom. You're going to have to do something, yeah. 或者北京那的混的，因俺说来当的开，挨到那天的，或者他还得那个阿的。 Galatians 5:1. Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty, that's freedom, wherewith Christ hath made us free, and be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage. You know, Jewish people had a lot of things that would tie them up. That means entangled, that you'll trip on something. I don't know what they call those things that have a weight at the end of the string. It'll be run like this, it has a man's throat, maybe at a sheep or something. It'll tangle up around their legs and it'll trip. And that's what the world can do to you. And it says, don't entangle yourself again with the yoke of bondage. You know, their problem was the law. Even though Jesus paid that price, they still want to keep it. Even though Jesus paid for that price, they want to still circumcise. They still want to do some things that are not necessary. Navajo is always very religious. They would like to have a ceremony. That's what they get in trouble with. And I'll say there is Kenalta. He died here. May he preach in from here. When I was here, they actually did maybe several. And you know, that entangles you. You believe something outside of what God is saying. You get caught in, and then you have certain practices that your old life used to do, or the music, or the friends, or the places you go. it entraps you, it entangles you again as a Christian. So God is saying, stay out of that. And how about going to 5:13? That's right there already. For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Not only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another. You know, man can live, you know, one of my friends said, we rented them a house. And I won this couple to the Lord. And then I put the sticker on the refrigerator. It says, not perfect, just forgiven. Ever heard that statement? Not perfect, just forgiven. Meaning, they still sin. They still drink. They still fool around. And that's what they were saying. Sure, you're perfect. You ought to stay perfect. How about Galatians somebody was saying, but actually that was a Friday, so I mean, he said, sometimes I get into cussing. He said, he claimed the Lord, but he said, I still cuss sometimes. I shouldn't do that, but I do. He knows it, but he hasn't been delivered from it. And Christians in there, it's all it on, just see it on there, Satan and Shepherds and you know, the plan of freedom is not of works now. So we can on this Galatians, as it was there, Galatians 3:10, don't it? Back the flip one page. So for as many are of the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, curses everyone that continue not in the things which are written in the book of the law to do them. Doji la go to a curse, like Galatians 2:6. Galatians 2:6, okay, flip over to the side somewhere. But of these who seem to be somewhat, whatever they were, it seems it maketh no matter to me. God accepteth no man's person. For they who seem to be somewhat in confidence add nothing to me, he said. They look like they got saved by themselves. Look like they saved. Look like everything comes from them. Paul said, that looks like somebody. It doesn't bother me. I'll come that way. By grace are you saved through faith, yeah. And that none of yourselves. It is the gift of God. The power of freedom. I was telling that I'm going to be doing the jail ministry again. We usually start with the book of John. And when we were here at verse 12. And we came back to it several times. It says, but as many, how many, maybe the whole world, as many as receive him. Jesus is being talked about as receive Jesus. To them gave he, that's God, gave he the power to become the sons of God. Even to them that believe. That's all you need, believe on his name. I told them, these inmates, I said, you have the power of eternity. When you receive him, God gives you the power to become the children of God. It's like signing your check. You know, your check is just a piece of paper with a bank that guarantees it has a date, it has an amount. That moment you sign your name, it becomes something. It's money. It might be your grading permit. It might be your birth certificate. You sign your name. You make it good. And some of these that got saved by just reading that verse of them. I said, you have the power to reject it or to accept it. It's yours, not mine. I'm just giving it to you. And you know, one guy just shed his tears, said, I want it. He said, I want it. I want to have it. You know, that was a great day. And you have that. Look at John 8. We're winding down to, I don't keep people sitting there for a long time, so I'll keep them under an hour. So John 8:32. Let's see. Alright. Ye shall know the truth from the word of God, and the truth shall make you free. The truth is going to do it. Not somebody, not but somebody's prayer. I mean, somebody can lay his hand on your head and say, yeah, you're saved. No. It's got to be the word of God. And that's why, and then it got to be coming from your mouth too. Romans 10 says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, it got to come from you, from the heart. And ye shall be free. Look at verse 36. If, that is, if you do believe, if the Son therefore shall make you free. Ye shall be free indeed. Yeah. 전에 너희 이딧 나서야 아셨더니 나께서 나더니 아코 God it or Jesus 이래 아코 인자 고야 아셔 지리게 에베 비예 Ile, betsi ile, atzi nahlelia, nizhi in leho atzi likit ahot a nahlelia, kona na tsosa chinji bukai la da ilisili, net is chinigi na tsosa kai nizhi in la da ilisili, kut au, oko kwa jan se bito tateo anakiege. Nini spelto zisot, nini e nade do chiseo da honet le yin do los. Hatemo anstra. Ako a yet. Inza la da no hane. Ako a yet. E nade chito. Jesus e asne a yet. Nade chito. That's freedom. My brother Raymond. He probably didn't come to get saved. I saw him up there at the altar at the chapter house. We had a meeting over there. Now he's here with us. He got saved. Maybe he was looking at my truck tires and said, hey, I like that one. You know, that was the Gap Boys. They'll take your spares and take your tool, everything. Clean you up if you're not tied down. He got saved and he's with us all these years. Thank the Lord, yeah. About that, Eggy. I was preaching, Jesus of Nazareth passeth by. Jesus of Nazareth passeth by at the Crescent Mesa. And then the guy began to weep. He said, I want that Jesus. I just wanted him to pass by me. I want him. You know that guy got saved? He wasn't with us here for some time. Still saved. And that's what's available this morning. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you again for just us here being in church. Bless those the hearers. We pray that if they need to be saved, they will find a way. And you said Jesus died, was buried, and rose again because they're sinful. All have sinned, you said, and come short of the glory. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, that he did it for me, and I want to take it as my own and get saved. And he says that prayer. They can be saved. Lord, thank you. And thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
We're gonna end by singing "The Lily of the Valley," page 447 in the dark blue songbook.